the truth, if you believe the official story and have any idea what the official story is, some of the details of it, then there is something wrong with your mind.
Mm-hmm.
Because you simply cannot believe the official story about the Twin Towers or Building 7 unless you believe in miracles. And in this case, you would have to believe that Allah performed the miracle if you believe that Al-Qaeda was responsible for bringing the buildings down.
Mm-hmm.
And let me stress why that is. Let me illustrate it with Building 7.
Sure.
There had been a long-standing controversy as to whether Building 7 came down at free-fall acceleration.
Mm-hmm.
The rate of, if you drop a brick off the top of the building, and going through the air, we're talking about free-fall through the air, not
right.
through a vacuum.
Mm-hmm.
And if the building came down in free-fall, the roof, the top floor, would have reached the ground at the same time the brick reached the ground. That would have meant that the top floor of the building went through the other 41 floors, with absolutely no resistance.
Right.
Well, we all know that's impossible. All that concrete, and particularly all that steel, 82 steel columns, just can't kind of jump out of the way or just melt into nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So free fall means zero resistance. That means everything has to be now. Now, what the 9/11 Truth Movement had always said is virtual free fall.
Mm-hmm.
Well, as the NIST group was getting ready to put out their final report, they put out a preliminary report for public comment in August of last year, and they said, free fall, you guys are talking about free fall, nowhere close to free fall, 40% slower than free fall, which would still be very fast. But
yeah,
nevertheless,
we're talking about seconds.
Yeah, yeah. And, David Chandler, who's a high school physics professor, who lives there in the Bay Area, he put out a video and showed that it not only was virtual free fall, but for 2.5 seconds, it was absolute free fall. So that means for about the first 2.5 seconds of the building coming down, it was encountering absolutely no resistance. And he put that on YouTube. He actually confronted the 9/11 Commission with it. And lo and behold, this was also a miracle. When they put out their final report in November, they said there were 2.25 seconds. They quibbled about 0.25 seconds. 2.25 seconds of gravity or free fall. And they still kept the previous theory, which was the theory of progressive collapse based on fire, which meant that the columns came down in not all at suddenly at once, but in an order. You know, 79 goes down, and then it knocks 80 down, and then it knocks 81 down, and then all the others go down in order. Well, that can't happen instantaneously. And Sunder, who's the Chaim Sunder, who's the head of the NIST team that put out this report, he explained this. He said not everything can happen at once, and it can't be free fall. But when they went into their November report, they said, well, okay, it's free fall. But they didn't change their theory. So they have a theory that rules out free fall, and yet, as an empirical fact, they admit free fall. And so that would be a miracle, because you would be violating one of the most fundamental principles of Newtonian physics. We're talking about junior high physics here.
And just a quick, I think, correction here. You mentioned Chandler confronted the 9/11 Commission. I think you meant NIST, right?
Yeah, the NIST. This
yes.
was at the, it was called the World Trade Center 7 Technical Briefing.
Mm-hmm.
And I discussed that at great length in my book. Thanks
yes, you
for
did.
That correction.
Yeah.
Now, let me add a thing here, since you brought up Van Jones. And so my point is, people who say something's wrong with Van Jones's mind, they need to understand that there has to be something wrong with your mind if you know what's in the 9/11, all these official reports, and you still say you believe them.
Mm-hmm.
So either you're being dishonest or you're simply ignorant about the facts, or in this case, the basic facts of physics.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here's a rather amazing thing that was sent to me last night. There's a magazine, a well-known old magazine in England called the New Statesman. This is a left-wing magazine. You're probably familiar with it.
I've heard of it. Mm-hmm.
It's been around for about 100 years, and most of us know it because it's the vehicle that John Pilger writes most of his articles for. Mm-hmm. And so you know this is, they allow very hard-hitting stuff in there. But, like a lot, and actually the majority of the left-wing organizations, they keep their distance from what they call conspiracy theories, refusing to admit that the official story about 9/11 is the original conspiracy theory.
Indeed.
And they want to ridicule us and say that, we're a terrible thing because we discredit the left and all of this. Well, nevertheless, in this magazine, the cover story is called 50 People Who Count in the World Today. And, of course, President Obama is number one. Hugo Chavez is number 44, for example.
Okay.
Osama bin Laden, in spite of the fact he's dead, is number 8. But you see, he's been falling down a little bit. A few years ago, he would have been the most important person. I guess being dad might hurt your influence.
It cuts into it, yeah.
But nevertheless, the point I'm getting to is that yours truly, believe it or not, is number 41.
Really?
Really. I was shocked, and then secondly, I was rather upset because it used to be in the 80s, I'd go to the gym, and these little old ladies would come up to me, think they're giving me a compliment, and say, you know, you look just like our President Bush, meaning, George Sr.
Uh-huh.
And I always hated that, the idea that I looked anything like George Bush, and of course, he's 41.
Mm-hmm.
And here I am, 41. Anyway, here's what they say about me. And they don't call me conspiracy theorist. They give category because they use that for Dan Brown. And by the way, he was number 50.
Oh.
So somehow I matter a little more than Dan Brown. That's a little hard to believe. But nevertheless.
It's just a more recent conspiracy.
Yeah. Now, yeah, this is a little more recent than that. Yeah, Jesus and Mary and so on. Now, it is a backhanded compliment. Here's what they say. Conspiracy theories are everywhere, and they always have been. In recent years, one of the most pernicious global myths has been that the U.S. government carried out, or at least colluded in, the 11 September 2001 attacks as a pretext for going to war. David Ray Griffin, a retired professor of religion, is the high priest of the truther, quote-unquote, movement. His books on the subject have lent a sheen of respectability. No reference to Charlie Sheen, of course.
Thank you.
Lent a sheen of respectability that appeals to people at the highest levels of government, from Michael Meacher to, you guessed it, Anthony Van Jones, who was recently forced to resign as Barack Obama's green jobs advisor after it emerged that he had signed a 9/11 truth petition in 2004. So, first of all, when you get over the shock of this and realize that's, quite a big thing to recognize the 9/11 truth movement as something quite important, even if it's important in a pernicious way.
And I thank you for the sheen that you've given it.
And so, but then the point here is that they ended the piece with that, or the little paragraph on me, it looks like, to show that obviously what I'm saying is false and not to be taken seriously in polite company, because Van Jones had to resign because he was influenced by this kind of nonsense.
Well, I think it's a really sad commentary, and I posted a blog item, and I have ranted about this on my podcast, Professor, that I think that the Obama team really blundered in giving the scalp of Van Jones to Glenn Beck and the lobby groups that are supporting him and that are also promoting the